Well, a jobs fair is being held today after ICE raids in Mississippi. We're leaving a lot of the plants understaffed. Rick Leventhal now has more from Morton, Mississippi. Hey, Rick.
Hey, Neil, a steady stream of people showing up at the building behind me. We're told 150 applicants in the first 3 hours of this job fair with about 30 minutes left to go. Cook Foods has not said how many people they're looking to hire, but the folks that we spoke with said they're definitely ready to go to work. Cook is just one of several chicken processing companies to get raided by ICE agents last week, with 680 workers detained for possible immigration violations. And of course, there's been a lot of criticism of the raids. Much of it focused on the separation of children from parents who worked at these chicken plants. ICE released a very strongly worded statement yesterday to try and clear up what it said were rumors and false information, saying every child who had two parents arrested last week had at least one parent released within 24 hours due to humanitarian reasons. We also expedited the processing of adults who identified they had a child in need of care. More than 300 were released by dawn the next day, and ICE says we are the only law enforcement agency that does such things to persons arrested by a federal law enforcement agency. ICE says the reality is adults with children are arrested across America every day, but you don't hear about it unless it involves ICE agents. Some of those released have ankle monitors and court dates, Neil. The rest are being detained in three separate facilities waiting on bond hearings and deportation proceedings, as Cook and the other companies are looking to fill those slots that were lost when those illegal workers were detained, Neil.
Rick, thank you very much. Rick Leventhal.